Do 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 do. Hello everyone and welcome back to some motherfucking Warframe. I'm back in here finally. I had to do some stuff today, but I didn't want to do a Warframe stream and then have to cut it midstream and then have to go back and start it again. So here I am on Warframe now. Actually the animation, yeah, on Warframe now. I want to start with, I already claimed the parts I left last Warframe stream off crafting. I already claimed those. And okay, sweet, rank 15 on that. As I'm saying, I already did one thing. I finished that relic one yesterday. That relic challenge. So I don't see any more. Oh, just scroll down. Yeah, there you go. I finished relic challenge yesterday. But I need to go to Fortuna. And I need to craft the MOA, and I need to craft the weapons that I planned on building. I claimed all those parts. I was gonna craft them yesterday, last night when I was on, but I asked Bryson, and he's like, "Nah, I just do it for the stream." I'm like, "I want to do it for the stream, so you guys can see me make it. I also just want to make it, so I don't have to go down here and do it." Let's see here, build kit gun. Chamber is going to be a rattle guts. Grip is going to be a brash, and then the loader is going to be a ram flare. So this is going to be my first one, which there's the gilded stats right there. It's going to be a status based weapon. Sadly it's puncture mostly, but whatever. Build, yes. There's kit gun one. And then the next one is going to be another rattle guts, and this one's going to have a shrewd grip. And then the loader is going to be the kill stream. That's what that one looks like. Right there. And again, this is essentially the same weapon, except it's a critical over a status this time. And that's pretty much the only difference. The base damage might be a little different, but whatever. Chamber is going to be a catchman this time with a steady slam grip and a killstream loader. That's what this one looks like. And this is going to be a critical strike one, critical chance one, build. And then this one's going to be a catchmoon, tremor, killstream. Which is going to be nearly the same thing. This has higher total damage. I think it's heat. Yeah, this one's heat this time. I think the other one wasn't heat. Wait, no, let's not do that yet. Oh, yeah, that one looks funky. Build. Yes. So I got all of those I need to build up. But I believe they do not count as any new mastery because they use the same... I don't think they count as mastery because they use the same parts and pieces and stuff. So there shouldn't be any new mastery there. It's just a new grip. Let's see here. And then configure a MOA companion. Model is the Nitus MOA with a Drex core, a Trux core, and a Drimper bracket, because this is the cheapest one I can build. I do not care about companions. I'll say this right here, right now, early into the stream. I do not care at all about companions. Companions, I could not give one shit about. Companions, to me, are just nothing but mastery fodder. I would call a companion mastery fodder. So companions here, essentially, like, look, here's my Emolga. It's essentially the core, and then I think all the default basic shit. If you look at my build on it, it's just whatever mods I can throw on. Essentially, so I mean, and that's pretty much all. That's pretty much all of them. All of these are pretty much just whatever mods I could throw on. Like, ooh, no build on it. Just whatever mods I could throw on it. That's how literally all these are. Look, I literally put this here. If you notice, I got this giant ember butt here. And then if you choose like a Dirga or whatever, I have a crumb here and ember butt. I literally put this here so you don't have to see them. Appearance. I don't care. Upgrade. I don't care. Hermit Animal Instinct. Medipet kit, done. Perfectly built. Oh yeah, wait, and then I need to go to companions. I did not put this in the title because I don't really consider it worthwhile enough. I will also be leveling up the Hellstrom. Which this I will actually bother to put. Split chamber, serration. Build complete. It's as good as it's gonna get. 100%, all mods used, perfect build. I don't care enough about that. I wonder, you know, Proteus, Zalta, Velox, and Strofa are the most important ones here. And then the MOA just is the MOA, and then the kit and primaries. But yeah, my goal is to hopefully level all these up. I need to do that gift to Lotus too, but that still has a few days. I don't need to. I probably should. I don't care at all about that. Alright, just looked at it. I don't care at all. Public. And let me double check that all my mods are on. I'm not going to start this without all my mods on. And I am going to have my mic muted majority of this stream. Mods. I don't remember exactly everything I was going to be doing, but I can always watch the video. I can watch back on my stream and remember everything. But I should remember everything as I get going. I'll be updating as I go. So, my mic's going to be muted. I might do that quest as a separate stream, just the whole quest as a stream. But mic will be muted most of the stream, and I will be listening to an audiobook. So, let's get going.
Position has been compromised. Defend the cargo until reinforcements arrive. Thank you. Reinforcements available. Do you choose to leave now or continue fighting? Continue to defend. You will be rewarded for your bravery.
Thank you.
Action is ready. Unless you can handle more of the enemy. That's the last of them. Objective is secure. Let's go home.
Anyone else picking up weird?
The enemy is at our doorstep. We must defend our equipment until reinforcements arrive.
The Grineer deteriorate over time. Is that what makes them violent?
Thank you.
Extraction is ready. Unless you kill more of the enemy. Keep fighting. Your opportunity to extract will appear soon.
Hold up. Detecting glass resonance. It's close. There's less than nothing left of who they once were.
Thank you.
available. Do you choose to leave now or continue fighting? That's the last of them. Objective is secure. Let's go home. The enemy is at our doorstep. You must defend our equipment until reinforcements arrive.
Ballistics and archaic weapons, crude and dangerous, just like the Grineer.
Come on.
extraction is ready. Unless you can handle more of the enemy. Continue to defend. You will be rewarded for your bravery.
Let's go on the offensive!
Thank you. remains available. Do you choose to leave now or continue fighting? That's the last of them. Objective is secure. Let's go home. Your mission is to break into enemy data vaults and steal any intelligence files you find. You're nearing the console. Trigger the attacks now, and they will start destroying the data. Tenno, be on the lookout for increased security measures. The enemy would rather destroy their data than get into our hands. Alarms! Data destruction is imminent. You need to hurry. Data integrity verified. Retrieval was successful. Like heavy activity. The target console is nearby. If you trigger the alarms now, the enemy will start destroying data. Alarms have been triggered. You need to retrieve that data before the data destruction is complete. Data is still intact.
Your crowns are safe in my grasp, O Parvos. Protect me!
Why the fuck does it say it's fucking not Max? It was Max with that, the fucking, without the bonus. It was Max without the bonus!
Intel suggests that our interest is in the vicinity. Search for the hostage and bring them home.
Corpus has tech weapons. We'll need to be careful.
Find the captive as soon as you can. We don't have much time. You are approaching the holding area. Careful. If the wardens detect you, they will surely initiate the execution sequence. The bypass is done. Go.
That was a close one.
Captive will be in one of these cells. Search them.
I will not forget this, Tenno.
Subject found. You need to bring the captive to safety. Protect them at all costs.
Got a weapon for me? I've got some scores to settle.
For the Lotus.
Before me, who's this that I see? The Outworlder buddy, long time absentee. How are you, baby?
Right now.
You like stories? Someone like you, Gaara, faced up to an Eidolon. My terrible choice to have to make. We all do what we can, Stardust. Someday, things will be different.
Keeping you alive. You know where to find me.
Step on up, quick like and snappy. I pay off some debt, you walk away happy. Now, what do you need? Mowers? We've got mowers, right? I always like to name them. You should name her. What's her name?
Welcome to the world, kiddo. See you later, Agitator.
Our position has been compromised. Defend the cargo until reinforcements arrive. extraction is ready. Unless you can handle the enemy. Keep fighting.
Ah! detecting glass resonance. It's close. Where are they coming from? Void. Who did this to you?
Reinforcements available. Do you choose to leave now or continue fighting? We're done here. The extraction team will take over from here. Time to evacuate.
Anyone else picking up weird signal shapes floating in the clouds just off Gas City? Nora's keen to hear from any listeners with info.
ready. Unless you can handle more of the enemy. Continue to defend. You will be rewarded for your bravery.
Thank you.
Reinforcements available. Do you choose to leave now or continue fighting? That's the last of them. Objective is secure. Let's go home. position has been compromised. Defend the cargo until reinforcements arrive.
Ballistics and archaic weapons, crude and dangerous, just like the Grineer. For the Lotus.
Reinforcements available. Do you choose to leave now or continue fighting? Keep fighting. Another opportunity to extract will appear soon. Continue to defend. You will be rewarded for your bravery.
Thank you.
action is ready. Unless you can handle more of the enemy. Keep fighting. Another opportunity to extract will appear soon.
Hold up. Detecting glass resonance. It's close. Cephalites. Time to smash some glass. gotta be a way to take these things down.
Reinforcements available. Do you choose to leave now or continue fighting? We're done here. The extraction team will take over from here. Time to evacuate. enemy is at our doorstep. You must defend our equipment until reinforcements arrive.
Grineer prey on the weak, but we prey on the Grineer.
Thank you. reinforcements available. Choose to leave now or continue fighting. Keep fighting. Another opportunity to extract will appear soon.
Thank you.
action is ready. Unless you can hear the roar of the enemy. Very impressive, Tenno. You held them all back. Time to get out of here. Our position has been compromised. Defend the cargo until reinforcements arrive.
We've got signals singing the same song as our victim. Careful now. There's less than nothing left of who they once were. But no, Glass.
make them.
Reinforcements available. Do you choose to leave now or continue fighting? Continue to defend. You will be rewarded for your bravery.
Thank you.
ready, so you can handle more of the enemy. We're done here. The extraction team will take over from here. Time to evacuate. reinforcements available. Do you choose to leave now or continue fighting? We're done here. The extraction team will take over from here. Time to evacuate.
Our position has been compromised. Defend the cargo until reinforcements arrive.
The Grineer used to be builders, but now all they make is war.
Thank you.
reinforcements available. Do you choose to leave now or continue fighting? Continue to defend. You will be rewarded for your bravery.
Thank you.
Extraction is ready. Unless you can handle more of the enemy. Keep fighting. Another opportunity to extract will appear soon. The enemy is at our doorstep. You must defend our equipment until reinforcements arrive.
The Grineer have no honor.
extraction is ready. Unless you can handle more of the... The enemy is at the doorstep. You must defend our equipment until reinforcements arrive.
The Grineer deteriorate over time. Is that what makes them violent?
Thank you.
action is ready. Unless you can handle more of the enemy. Keep fighting. Another opportunity to extract will appear soon.
Thank you.
reinforcements available. Do you choose to leave now or continue fighting? We're done here. The extraction team will take over from here. Time to evacuate. The enemy is at our doorstep. We must defend our equipment until reinforcements arrive.
Thank you.
reinforcements available. Do you choose to leave now or continue fighting? Keep fighting. Another opportunity to extract will appear soon.
And we will counter.
Thank you.
extraction is ready. Unless you can handle more of the enemy. Very impressive, Tenno. You held them all back. Time to get out of here. Our position has been compromised. Defend the cargo until reinforcements arrive.
Thank you.
reinforcements available. Do you choose to leave or continue fighting? Keep fighting. Another opportunity to extract will appear soon.
Yeah.
extraction is ready. Unless you can handle more of the enemy. We're done here. The extraction team will take over from here. Time to evacuate.
Alrighty, I should be unmuted now. Let's just finish up my build. Now, in the current title, it says I'm going to be doing my new kit gun primaries. I'm just going to scratch that. I've been live for 3 hours and 40 minutes. I could, but that's 4 kit gun primaries. I'm just going to replace my streamline with a rank 9 streamline instead of that rank 8 one. If I can even find it. Streamline. There we go. So I got the 5% more efficiency. My Protea is done, and then my Strofa upgrade. And I was originally gonna do a Blood Rush. I don't remember how Blood Rush works on Gunblades. I don't remember if Blood Rush works in terms of you can shoot them and it counts for your combo. I don't remember if shooting them actually raised your combo multiplier, if it was you had to hit them, because I remember there was something weird like that where, at least in the past, where you had to hit them with the blade itself for Blood Rush to actually, like, work. But since they reworked melee, I don't know if shooting actually counts or not. I assume it doesn't anymore. And I said I was going to go for Buzzkill, because that will raise my slash pretty much nearly the same stat as heat, as my heat damage is. And then I got my viral there already, to make it a viral slash heat very high stat anyway. And then with the True Steel here, since they reworked the True Steel and the other like mods like this that used to be complete trash, to make them really good, I should be good here. And I want to go ahead and actually test these weapons. I don't know what they're called. I want to go ahead and test these weapons out against actual high levels now. I don't know what that one is. I want to test these weapons against actual high levels to see how it performs. Alright, where's my notepad? Velox, I think, is this one. Velox, and then this one is the Stalta. So yeah, I don't really care for testing the Warframe, but I do want to test the weapons and see how they do against fairly high leveled enemies real quick, and then I shall end the stream. I'm just going to get rid of that part and make you some more. There we go. So here, skip all of that. Festival, Samaris. I did buy that. I was going to say, I didn't buy the ballroom. Everyone's been using the ballroom simulacrum recently, and I'm like, I never bought that. I did buy it. I've actually never been in here. I've only seen it in videos. Ooh. Corrupted Bomber, level 170, invincibility, and simulate. Hello, little one. So yeah, I have 17 left out of a 40-round mag. I mean, it's not horrible. Just regular shooting, it's not horrible with this build. Let's test the charge shot. As expected, the charge shot does next to nothing on a 170 corrupted bombard. It's not really worth the effort of using the charge shot, but I guess if there's like big group of weak enemies, it'd be fairly useful to use. But otherwise, this weapon anyway, the Stalta, the new primary, you're better off just shooting them. See, I had 16 left that one, but I was getting some higher numbers there, crit-wise and stuff. Let's go to the Velox. This is the weapon I was really impressed with. I thought it was a lot better than I didn't really look at the stats too closely, but I didn't think it was going to be great of a weapon. I mean, that took me 62 bullets to kill him, but I think I also missed the first, like, 20 shots. Yeah, see, I had 11 bullets left over that time. So, I mean, it takes about a whole magazine to kill him. Takes about a whole magazine for me to kill this 170 corrupted bombard. But, I mean, if you're just trying to shoot through a crowd, I mean, it's pretty decent. I mean, it, you know, with this build anyway, I got the high slash, you got the high crit, you know, the high slash, high crit, high status going off. It's not too bad. And then the one I'm the most questionable about is the Gunblade. I don't know any of the stance combos for the Gunblade. So let me actually just kill him. Could have just shot him, I guess. Kill enemies. Simulate. I never play Gunblades. I don't like using Gunblades. So I don't know any of the stances or combos for him. Ooh, I did not mean to do that. Hit the button on my mouse. I've got 12. My mouse has 12 buttons on size, one of those MMO mice. See, I mean, this is taking me a lifetime and a half to kill him. But that's partly because I'm missing everything, and partly because I don't ever use Gunblades ever. I used to use the Redeemer when they first added focus to the game, like the Nerimon and stuff like that. I used to use the Redeemer all the time because I would just play Loki and go invisible, and then I'd cross map people with the Redeemer. With my the focus bonus, I don't know what it's called. It's like the focus little boost thing you find on the map and you collect. So I used to use Redeemer all the time. I don't know where Redeemer is under used. Yeah, right here. See, so I used to use Redeemer all the time, but that's the most I have on any Gunblade. 7,000 kills, no doubt, guaranteed most on any Gunblade. But otherwise, yeah. Hello, little guy. I mean, my Lurks, I can kill him way faster with the Lurks. Oh, yeah, but no, that's not what I want to test. I remember what I was going to do now. I was going to test shooting him. Okay, shooting does raise the combo. Because I'm pretty sure when Blood Rush first came out, at least either when Blood Rush first came out or whatever, yeah, I think it was when it first came out, it didn't work when you shot the enemies, I'm pretty sure. Malcolm, okay. Yeah, I'm pretty sure it didn't work when you shot the enemies originally, but knowing that it shoots the enemies now, I'm not as against. So, I mean, yeah, my two builds for the Strofa would be either my current build with the slash to have really high slash and viral on here, then I guess the heat. I mean, you could easily get rid of that molten impact for volcanic edge to get a little bit more status if you want a little bit more status chance. But I'd rather just go for this for really high numbers, and then if I do get that status proc, I get the viral and heat going off. But you could easily get rid of this buzzkill, which, I mean, just raises overall just total damage, and you can easily get rid of that or change that. Instead of having a dash there, you could have a V there for Blood Rush. Or what you can do is you can do something like this, where you go ahead and keep that dash, at least if you're using the same build I have, you can keep that dash and put it on like a molten impact if you have the exact same build. And then now I can just swap between buzzkill and Blood Rush. So let's go ahead and test Blood Rush, actually. Try to do a fairly controlled killing anyway, I guess. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So I got a 5x80 combo there. I don't know if that's the best way to calculate killing him with the melee like that. But that's how I'm going to figure it out. I had an 5x80 hit combo or whatever. And then now I'm going to put on my 11 mod of buzzkill. And I'm not aiming for the head on this. I'm just aiming for hitting him. That had an 88. So, I mean, they performed about the same. There wasn't really much of a difference there. Now, granted, I think for end game, if you're using this weapon on a survival, I think Blood Rush would be better than MAME. Or not MAME, whatever the fuck it's called. I don't know what it's called. I think if you're doing this, yeah, I mean, look, I'm at it 6 times now and he's not dead yet. 7 times. See, I think the better build overall would be the Blood Rush. If you're fighting weak enemies, you know, if you're fighting enemies, you know, probably level 100 or lower, it wouldn't matter what. I mean, generally doesn't matter whatsoever. If you're just going through the star chart playing normally, if you're just doing like this, you know, the sortie, you know, like sortie would be the highest level you'd be fighting. This build would work perfectly fine. But otherwise, if you're gonna be going anywhere above sortie level, I'd say use a Blood Rush build. So either work. I'm gonna actually update my build on Overframe, because after testing it now, I'm going to change, get rid of that dash there, put a dash there. I want to do that because I want to organize it more, and then I want to put a Blood Rush right here. And mine is only rank 7 because I am too lazy to rank it up. Save and save. So I'm going to make that my permanent build. You can always look at other people's builds. These are my builds anyway. They're on my Overframe, if you can find it. I mean, you got my thing up here, but you know, it's probably easy to find. But yeah, nearly 4 hour stream of just pretty much just power leveling. Now, I did say earlier in the title, which is now changed, that I would be doing my kit gun primaries. So if I just search kit gun, I was going to be doing all of these different weapons in this stream. But I will not be doing that this stream. I'm thinking about streaming this later tonight, if not tomorrow. So I'm going to be back on Warframe later today, if not tomorrow. And when I'm on tomorrow, I'm probably going to start with not this. From what I was gleaming from the wiki and Overframe. On Overframe, if you look here, it says update 20 at the Deadlock Protocol. And you got Protea, who I just finished, Valex, who I just finished, Stalta, who I just finished, and Strofa that I just finished. But you also got the Zorus over here, which I do not own the Zorus. It's a melee glaive type weapon, and if we go over to my melees, if you look in the Zorus, search Zorus, I do not own it, so it's not in my list of melees here. And when you go show profile and you hit equipment, says I've done 563 out of 563, so it's not showing up here. But when I looked at the weapon on the wiki, that is Blizzard, not this. But when I went to Warframe, yeah, I think I did that. No, Warframe Zorus. Yep, and I went here, and when I looked at the Warframe Zorus here, I saw it says the glaive using the Granum Spectre Particle Theory. Whatever, I don't care, but on the wiki here, it's saying the blueprint, the core, the handle, and the blade are obtained during the Deadlock Protocol. Additional blueprints can be bought from Cephalon Samaris. Which I noticed they were doing that for things that you can only obtain once. They were making it to where you could buy it from Samaris, which is amazing. But when it said Deadlock Protocol, I assumed it meant the quest. And when I looked at it, it was the quest. It says type optional quest. I cannot get that weapon until I do the quest. So I think when I stream this game later tonight or tomorrow, I will be doing the Deadlock Protocol quest, and I will be obtaining that weapon. And as such, from obtaining that weapon, I'll probably do the quest and level up that weapon. And while I'm leveling up that weapon, I'll probably start on my kit guns. And I think actually I don't think I can, because I think I did that last night. No, I didn't do that. I don't remember if I did that last night or not. I might do my Fortuna stuff to get more standing, because I'm going to need to get more. No, it's only 5,000 guild, and so there'd be 20,000. I should have enough standing then. I think I have over 20,000 standing. Either way, I might need to get more standing. I'll definitely probably need to get more stuff to guild those weapons and level them up. But I'm not too worried about those weapons because they don't count as mastery. They're new kitgun primaries, but they're using the same strikes, and the strikes are what count for mastery. Or not the strikes, you know, the barrels, or, you know, whatever, the rattle guts and the catch moon, and those are what the mastery is, and those are all the same. So I'm just going to end this here, and before I keep rambling, I guess, and...